a lot of people when they were kids wanted to be a policeman or a fireman or a clown. I did have a brief period where I wanted to be a clown, but I always wanted to have my own music store because then I could listen to whatever I wanted to, which I couldn't do at home. Although, of course, I also wanted to be the next member of Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young and Hamilton. I thought that would have been a great band too, but that never happened. But the opportunity to get my own store did happen. I basically got started by going around to yard sales and buying records on the cheap. And so one summer I just took all my savings out of the bank and bought up a bunch of records in yard sales and loaded them up and started selling one Sunday a month. And then it became two Sundays. I'd go to Philadelphia and set up, and then Pittsburgh, and then D.C., then Wayne, New Jersey, Allentown, and the next thing you know, I was doing five or six record shows a month on the weekends. And at some point, I was making more money on a weekend selling records than 3 months at my regular job. I opened up the store in 1991. By the time I opened the store, vinyl was sort of, as they were saying, was dying off and on its way out. I loved it so much that I stuck with it. Now it's gone from 10% of my business to about 50% of my business. Between 1997 and 2007, it's increased. Which also means that CDs have gone from 90% of my business to 50% of my business as well, but for me that's a fair trade. I have done other things periodically. I deal with DVDs some. I've delved into used guitars for a number of years, and that's kind of waning. Primarily, I started out records, CDs, and I'm pretty much back to that, and that's my main focus now. My name is Paul Hamilton, and this is not just an occupation, it is my hobby. I can't speak for other stores that operate the way I do, independent, quote-unquote, mom-and-pop stores, because I know some people that do that. I know quite a few people that do that or used to do that. A lot of them are no longer in business. And some of that I attribute to, I hate to say it, they all got away from vinyl. And I saw that coming. I'm glad I stuck with vinyl. But what really separates an independent store from a chain is you walk into here and you say, I'm looking for Lefty Frizzell or Django Reinhardt or Irish busker music. I'll know what you're talking about. I don't think you can walk into, I won't mention names, but stores that sell appliances and televisions and computers and talk to one of their geeks, they're not going to know what you're talking about. They'll know who Britney Spears is, and they'll know, they might know who Miles Davis is, but they won't have any in stock. But you have to love what you do if you're going to stay in the music business right now. I happen to love what I do, and at my age now, I am no longer qualified to do anything else, so I better stick with it.